And now, it's time for another Dice Tower Review with Tom Vassell.
Hey everybody, I'm Tom Vassell, and today we're taking a look at Super Skill Pinball Ramp It Up. Now, I already reviewed Super Skill Pinball last year, the first one that came out, but if you've never heard of that one, don't worry about it. You do not need to have played that one. It's not an expansion. This is a sequel. This one's pretty much the exact same game as the first one, except this one has that upper section that is by far my favorite thing in pinball games. When I'll ignore everything else just to get the ball into the upper section. One of my favorite pinball games in the world is at the Pinball Museum in Las Vegas, where there was one with like four levels and you just try to get it up to the next level. There's just something about that that I find incredibly fun. I don't know why. And that's what's in this game. Now, this is a roll and write game where you roll dice and then you write with erasable markers moving a ball around. It's a 1-4 player game. So let's show you how it works and then we'll come back. There are four different pinball games included in this set, and I'm going to show you how to play on the most basic one of them, Go for Gold. So you'll notice that each pinball board has the bottom and the top part of this board. This is where you're going to keep score. Each player has an erasable marker, and you'll just keep track of your score here. And then you'll notice there's a whole ton of other things on here. But the most important here is your ball, which is going to come in. You're going to play three rounds in this game. The ball is going to bounce around, bounce around, bounce around. Eventually, it's going to go through the flippers. And then round one is over, and you'll keep going. Now, when your round one is over, you'll play in the round two and round three, even if other players are in different rounds. They might still have their first ball going, but you'll start with your second ball. And at the end, after three balls, whoever has the highest score is the winner. The game revolves around two dice. One person will roll these dice the whole game. And when you roll them, that's going to give each player two different numbers to work with. Now, you may not like the numbers you get, and that's going to probably happen for sure. You can change a number to another number only for you, not for other players. But if you do so, that's a nudge. You can do three nudges. And when you do a nudge, you write the difference between the new number. So let's say I roll a 1 and a 6 and I really want it a 4. Well, then 6 to 4 is 2, and I would write 2 down there, the difference. And that matters because the game might tilt. You might lose your ball the next turn. If the difference between the dice on the next roll is smaller than that number, then you've tilted. So the more you change a number, the more dangerous it is. But either way, after you get the number, you pick whichever number you're going to use, you then decide where the ball goes next. When you're playing this game, the ball is going to be constantly moving. So when you pick your number, let's say I pick the number 6, I'm going to move it into the next section. When it starts, it shoots into this section. After that, it constantly goes down. It would go down to this section, farther down to the section below that, or down here to the bottom. You can always skip a section if you want to. And in fact, if there's no numbers available of the two numbers that are rolled and you don't want to nudge it or whatever, you might have to go all the way down to the next section. When you get to the bottom, you'll use your flippers to hit it back up. When you use a flipper to hit the ball, you're going to pick one of the numbers. So let's say it was here at the bottom and I rolled a 6. Then I can say, oh, I'm going to use this 6 and hit it with the red flipper. When you hit something with the red flipper, it goes back up to a red number. So on this board, all these are red. These here are red and yellow. These are red over here, but these are all yellow. Or I could even use this red arrow to shoot it into the upper section of the board where it will hit the blue flipper, and then the blue flipper hits it to something that's blue. So that's how the game works, essentially. When you pick a number, so let's say, for example, we started the game and you saw I rolled a 1 and a 6, so I decide I'm going to use the 6 here to roll. I'm then going to cross off or use this whole section, put a thing around it, to show that I've used that 6. Now this, a 5 or a 6 would work for that. And then when I come down, I'm gonna roll the dice again. So here I get a 1 and a 5. So I make it come down and I get this 1 here. And then I roll again and I get a 3 and a 5. Now normally I have to come down a section, but in these bumpers, you're allowed to keep going around them if you roll the next number. So you see this arrow points here? There is a 3 there. So I can go here and keep going around. Now, whenever you cross off a number, like I'm doing, you can't do it again, but if you ever cross off all the numbers in a section, where I box all of those, and there's a single line around them, then those all go away and I get to do it again. And that's how you get bonuses. Everything in this game is gonna give you bonuses as you do it. These top three here, when they're all done, for example, give me a skill shot. I can pick any number here, and in the future, instead of using a number on a die, I can erase that and say, I got a three. The bumpers give you 1 point, and you can just keep going around and around. When you come down here and hit these targets on the sides, when you get all of those, you can pick one of these bonuses, and these bonuses will give you extra points or make some things up here worth more points. When you come down to the flipper you have to cross off, you'll notice that these are dotted down here at the bottom when you hit the flippers, and that's because those don't cross, you don't erase those until you lose a ball. Once all these are filled up, and these two, and these even on the side, and you come through and the ball's out, or you have no more spots to hit it to, the ball comes out, then you'll erase those. Meanwhile, like I said, you're also trying to hit it into this upper section where you can get extra points for looping it around here, or if you hit these in order, you get points, or if you drop down in the falls, you can get points. And there's a lot of different things going on in this game, and I'm not gonna go through all the different bonus rules, but essentially, by hitting these things on the side, you can get bonuses that might even, you have multi-ball, where two balls are going at once. When that happens, you use both numbers on the dice. You have one to one ball and one to the other. You get the extra balls, you'll get extra points, but you have less control because of that. But eventually, you can see the flippers can hit it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 times maximum. After that, I mean, and there's other things that could happen, but after that, eventually the ball is gonna come out, and then you just start with your next ball. Again, it comes in here, and again, you can be playing that ball while other people are playing theirs. Meanwhile, you're keeping your score up here. There's a lot of things that are gonna give you single points as you hit them. You can see here, these give you points, the bumpers give you points, but by filling in whole sections, like for example, if I hit all the falls here, I can get 20 points. If I get some of these bonuses, I can double points in other places. And again, when everyone's done with their third ball, whoever has the most points here is the winner. As I said, there are four boards included in the game. And so you're playing these different boards, and each board has the same basic rules where the ball is going to come in and fall down and you can hit it up or go into this upper section through various ways, but they all have special rules. This is probably my favorite of the group, because here you have a police officer or security guard who's moving around, you're trying to rob a casino. If you have your ball in the same spot, that ball gets sent to jail where you need to roll doubles or fill one of your flipper boxes down here to get it out. That's not great. But at the same time, there's all kinds of cool casino type things that you can get bonus points, and you can even ignore the guard with one of your bonuses. So there's a lot of fun there. Then we have top speed, which is, this one's fun because it has numbers that go above 6. You can see there's 7, 8, 9 even here. And that's because you have a speed. You'll start at speed 0, you keep track of your speed, and when you shoot up here in the nitro zone, you can increase, or even there's different spots where you can lose speed. And the speed also is determined by the ball, like your ball can't go up to 3 speed until the third ball, but it gives you that kind of like, wow, my speed is going up and stuff. This is a little bit simpler than the casino board, but it's gonna be a little bit more keeping an eye on everything, maybe some more skill involved because you wanna try to keep your speed in the right spot. And then finally, the last one here is Pin Pals. Now, I actually don't have the right combo because in Pin Pals, you actually play this one with a partner, which is a little odd. Maybe someone can help me out here. I've never played pinball games with partners before, but this one's set up to do that. And if you do play this one solo, you either ignore teammate bonuses because there's different teammate bonuses on here, or you play two different boards at the same time, which I found to be a little overwhelming. I find it enough work to keep track of one board, let alone two of them. You can play one without the teammate bonuses, but I think this one just best played with multiple players. It's probably, I mean, theme-wise, I really like it. I like having, you know, Abraham Lincoln here or Hay Bale Hicks. You know, that's fun. And I like the theming a lot, but it's probably my least favorite of the four boards. My favorite being the casino board itself. Anyway, that's how you play. All right, the game comes with enough components for four players. Technically, you could play with more, I guess, if you bought two sets, but you know, you're gonna need two boards per player, and they're double-sided, and so it's pretty easy to set up. And I have to say, the visualization of having a second section to shoot into is a lot of fun. The artwork is, this is straight pinball stuff, looks really good. I've always liked the way these little pinballs look like. They look like an actual ball. The dice are good quality, and there's two sets of rules. You have a very quick start, simple thing. The game itself teaches you to play essentially with the basic board here, and then gives you specific rules on each of the other ones. Now, these have a decent amount of rules. You'll notice, like I said, the casino one had more rules than anything else than any other pages. I believe this one had 2, 4, 6 pages. Pin Pals had 4 pages, and Top Speed, well, Top Speed had 6 pages too. But you can just play one. Once you play one, it's really easy to understand the others. You just gotta understand how the little bonuses and things work. Now, I love the first Super Skill Pinball, so I'll be one. I love this one too. This is really an entertaining game for me because I'm a big pinball fan, and I feel like this is a pretty faithful recreation of pinball. Yeah, it's a little slower. You roll dice, boom, boom, boom. But things like the bumpers, moving it around where you're just watching it go there. The nudging, something I'm really terrible at in real pinball, but it's a big deal. I used to remember my mom talking about when you needed to nudge the table. And don't nudge it too far, you tilt it. I like that concept. I like going into the upper section. I also like that the four pinball tables in here feel very different. Now, like I said, my least favorite one is the team one. And that's just because, well, I'll come back to this in a second, but that's because I don't really want to work with someone else as much. I'm kind of focusing on my own thing. But it's still a fine table. My favorite in here is the casino one, but I found all of them to be fun playing. But let's come back. The reason the teammate one is possibly my least favorite is because by its very nature, Super Skill Pinball is a bit of a multiplayer solitaire game. Yes, one person rolls a dice and everyone works off those, but you don't really affect each other, except in that teammate one. And in which case, if that's a problem you have with Super Skill Pinball, you'll like that table is included. But I found that Super Skill Pinball is on my list now of games that I really like to play solo. I like rolling the dice, deciding where the ball goes next, moving on. I can play really fast. I can get a game done in, well, maybe not 20 minutes, but pretty close to that time frame. And I don't have to think about things. I don't have to sit there and wait for someone else to go, where am I gonna hit the ball next? You know, I don't have to wait for that. And if you like solitaire style games, this works really well. It doesn't have to be solitaire. You can play with a bunch of people. In fact, I guess if you had 80 sets of this, you could call out two numbers and the whole room is writing their numbers down. I mean, I guess it could go to infinity number of players. But because you are basically working on your own board, it's something that I just really found to be an enjoyable thing to play by myself. And so, I give it another high rating for that. Just really lots of fun. So, fantastic set. There's more on the way. They just announced a Star Trek version of this. So I'm looking forward to seeing that. And I'm also excited because I'm pretty sure that I can fit this and the original one in the same box. It's gonna be close, but I think it can be done. I'm about to try it out in a second anyway to see, but If it's not, it's only going to lift the lid by a bit. So that's convenient for storage purposes too. But if you like pinball, this is the best board game to simulate it. There's only a few out there anyway. This one simulates it well. If you like roll and write games, I think this is one of the best of those too. So that's Super Skill Pinball. Ramp it up. I'm Tom Vassell. You've been watching the Dice Tower. Dice Tower Judgment, excellent.